Good morning, children. Today it is my lecture 20 under gravitation chapter. Hope in the previous class we were solving problems. Today I'll solve some more problems based on different types regarding the gravitation chapter. Okay? Let me write today whatever the problems we solve. I'll write the formulas first and then we let us proceed for the problems. And today let us learn the one escape velocity, orbital velocity, gravitational potential energy, one more kinetic energy, total energy, potential energy, all those things based on gravitation. Okay, these formulas let me write first and let us go for the remaining problems. In the previous class, we have learnt Kepler's laws and also we have learnt the one third law, Kepler's laws, based on that we have solved problem, and also we have solved time period of the one, the satellite or maybe the planet, and also we have learnt one more, the one Newton's universal law of gravitation, acceleration due to gravity, and also we have learnt some more problems based on acceleration due to gravity at altitudes and depth. Okay. So these were the problems we have solved. In the last class we have solved acceleration due to gravity at some height, nothing but altitude. Suppose if it is close to the surface of the earth, we have one more formula. Based on that, I have also solved today one problem and let us proceed for the remaining problems. Okay?
One more formula based on the one gravitational potential. At that time we write the one gravitational potential energy, one more gravitational potential. I write gravitational potential energy is represented by symbol U, where U is equal to, it is nothing but minus G, capital M, small m, by R. You can write small r, okay, where R represents, that is R plus H. At that time you can take small r is equal to R plus H, using that let us calculate. And one more we have, that is gravitational potential, which is represented by symbol, that is nothing but one more formula we have, that is formula, this is gravitational potential. At that potential, where you know potential energy per unit mass, at that time we have the formula where it is minus gm by r. Okay, gravitational potential per unit, potential energy per unit mass is gravitational potential. But you remember u is nothing but potential energy, that is expressed in, u is expressed in, that is joules, it is expressed in joules. What about v? V is expressed in potential. Potential means gravitational potential energy per unit mass, I said. So it is V is expressed in joules per kg. Joules per kg. This is the one formula we have. And one more we come across, the next one, that is nothing but potential energy. Potential energy is represented by, where potential energy number, this is sixth formula. Potential energy is equal to, that is minus G capital M divided by, if you write small r, it is understood, it is R plus H, and you can also write nothing but in terms of R plus H also. This is potential energy. Okay, and potential energy is expressed in, always you know potential energy is in joules. Right, next number 7, where we come across the one kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is always positive, I said, and kinetic energy is represented by, that is nothing but gmm by, that is half gmm by r plus h. Here you can say it is represented by, that is half gmm by r plus h. Always it is positive, so please remember half gmm by r plus h. This is also expressed in, kinetic energy is expressed in joules. Next, one more we come across, total energy. When total energy is nothing but, you can also write in terms of like this, sum of kinetic energy plus potential energy like this, or you can also write total energy is equal to, that is again it will get minus here, 1 by 2, that is nothing but capital G, capital M, small m divided by R plus H, where you have this. That is nothing but total energy. Total energy is always, it is nothing but, again, similar to potential energy, but it is also negative. So, we have these formulas. Based on this, let us solve the problems. And in this, the one time period, you already know the formula. Using the one condition we know, it is 4 pi square r cube divided by, that is g, and that is nothing but r plus, that is we have learned under the condition GM, right, where the Kepler's laws. So these are the formulas, you just remember. Let me solve based on this some problems today. Okay, alright. Now just let me write one problem based on the acceleration due to gravity at 30 joules, which is, find the acceleration due to gravity at a point 64 kilometer above the surface. That problem will let us solve. Maybe I think the number is 11th problem. Find the acceleration due to gravity. Find the acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity at a point. At a point 64 kilometer above the surface of the earth. the earth. Now please observe, at this time which is very close, already you know this is earth, which is center, here it is R, yes, slightly above, which is H, nothing but which is 64. Here at this position we have to calculate D dash, where H is equal to 64 kilometer. At this position you have to calculate what is the acceleration due to gravity. So which is very close to the surface, you already know R. R value 6400 kilometer. So using that, let us take this formula here, because H is much much smaller than R. So let us take this formula. Please observe, which is G dash is equal to G times of 1 minus 2H by, that is R. Right? Here, where H is equal to 64 kilometer and you know R is equal to, H is equal to 64 kilometer and R is equal to 6400 kilometer. And I will never convert here, because here this is in kilometer, this is in kilometer. Both gets cancelled, so need not convert, directly you can write the values. Okay, at that time I write G dash is equal to G times of, that is nothing but 1 minus, what is G? Exactly on the surface of the earth it will be 9.8, you know. So let me write D exactly on the surface of the earth, which is 9.8 itself. So let me write G is equal to 9.8 meters per second square. So I write substituting the value, which is 9.8, 1 minus 2H, 2 into 64 divided by R, 6400 kilometer. This is also in kilometer, this is in kilometer, it both gets cancelled. So if you just cancel this, then you can write here, 64 ones are 6400, sir, 2 ones are, again you get, right, 1 by 15. So G dash is equal to 9.8, 1 minus, it is 1 by 50 you get. So 50 minus 1 is 49, 49 by 50 you get. If you take the LCM, 49 by 50 means, again you get, which is of 9.604. I can write like this only, that is G dash is equal to 9.604 meters per second square. So I have solved when it is close to the surface of the earth. This is one type problem. Okay? Right. I think you have followed this. In the earlier class you have solved which is slightly above the surface. At that time you have solved one more problem. Okay? Now, let me go for the next problem based on escape velocity. Neglecting air resistance find the minimum velocity a body must have in order to escape from the earth. From the earth, where radius of the earth is equal to 6370 kilometer and G is equal to 9.81 meters per second. 8 square. So this is what they have given. Usually you used to take 6400, but in this problem they have given the value, whatever the value they have given, based on that you have to calculate. You need not worry about the values. Okay, here in this case they have given G is 9.81 and RE is 6370 km. Whatever is given, let us take. Already they have given small g here. So let us use among these two formulas, let us take this formula, because we have small g and capital R. So let me take VE is equal to root of 2GR. So you can write root of 2G. 2 into 9.81 into R. R is 6370. Right? Remember, we are expressing escape velocity in meters per second. But remember here, this is in meters per second square, which is SI unit. But this is in kilometer. So first let us calculate. What is it? RE is equal to 6370 kilometer. It is. First I should convert to meters. 8 to 10 raised to 3 meters. Right? So let me just multiply by. This is 10 raised to 3. Then it will be in meters. So if you use all this, you get the value, it is of 11.2, that is nothing but 11,179 meters per second. That is 11.179 meters per second. After the multiplying and taking square root, you get this. Okay, but here remember, this is here. If you take this decimal, you can just take the one round off. When you round off this, since it is more than 5, you can add to the previous number 1. So you are getting, which is equal to 11.2 kilometers per second. You know this rounding off, significant figures in the first chapter you have learned. Like this, we write 11.2 kilometers per second. Which is escape velocity of the earth, and you already know using small g you have calculated this. Right? Okay. Now let me solve one more problem based on this type. Because we have solved using small g, let me solve one more type of based on capital G. Right? Let me go for the next problem. That is problem number 13.
Mass 1 by 9 and
radius 1 by 2 that of the earth.
Think you are following now, but you know this
velocity of the earth. So I write, this is V of mass is equal to 1 by 9, and this 2 will go to numerator, this is 2 by 1, and this itself will become, this is escape velocity of the earth. Okay, this is because the, for this we should write square root. For this already we have 2 gm by r, I will split like this, 2 gm by r, like this. Completely for this I can substitute ve. Suppose if I substitute ve, then 2 by 9, where v of mass is equal to 2 by 9 under root into ve. This is our formula. Already we know escape velocity is 11.2 is given, and already they have said 2 by root 2 by 9, that square root we have to take. If you just divide, you get the value which is equal to, let me write the final answer here. Escape velocity is equal to, it is root 2 by 9 into 11.2 kilometer per second. Therefore, E is equal to root 2 by 9, if you take the square root, and finally you get 5.280 kilometer per second. This is the one you can observe for escape velocity. I think now you have followed using capital G and M. First they have the escape velocity of the earth value, and we know the formula for escape velocity of the earth formula, and they are comparing this to the escape velocity of mass. So we have written using the same formula, we have written as per the given question, and we have also taken the conditions as per the question. We have taken the conditions and substituting, and finally we split for this, and we rewrite for 2 gm by r is ve, and substituting that value you get this answer. It is 5.280 km per second. Hope you understood this escape velocity of two different types. Okay. Now let me go for the next type problem based on orbital velocity. Okay, let me just go for the next problem, which is the rotating problem based on orbital velocity. Problem number 14 based on orbital velocity. An artificial satellite velocity. observe here, in this problem, they have given artificial satellite which revolves in a circular orbit at a height 600 km above the surface. What is the orbital velocity? They are asking. And they have given height here. So please observe, this is the Earth surface. From here to here, this will be the R. At some height, nothing but that is H, which is 600 km. Here, this is the one orbital velocity we have here. At this position, we have to calculate what is the orbital velocity at 600 km height. And they have given RE and G. Suppose if we are using orbital velocity formula, please observe. If you are using this formula, orbital velocity, Gm by R. But remember, here this is capital R is radius. And here I have given height. So for your convenience, I just write from here to here. Alright, this is small r. Means small r is equal to R plus H. Alright friends. Then I can rewrite the formula for this. Here this is R already given 6400 km plus 600 km. Totally it is 6400 plus 600, you get 7000 km. This is small r. So we have made this condition. And if I use this formula, if I take this formula where I write V naught is equal to root of Gm by small r. I write root of Gm by small r. Because we know the small r is r plus h. Right? Using that, let us calculate. Now, let me write this condition, but here they did not give anywhere mass. They did not give mass. But we know g. You did not worry for g. But mass is not given. So, what shall I do? We have one more condition where small g is equal to Gm by r square. Therefore, g r square is equal to Gm. So, what I just do is, I write this as where Gm is equal to gr square. So I rewrite the formula. V naught is equal to root of, that is gr square by small r. I think now you are able to catch the question. Where the small r is r plus h, capital R is the one with r radius of the r, and g you already know. Using this we have done. And nowhere we come across here mass, so need not worry about it. All these values are given. Let us substitute. Okay, right. Now if I just rewrite, here we get G is given, which is 9.8, right? And here they have said this R is in kilometer, this is in also kilometer. So let me write first one where R is equal to, this is R is equal to 6400 kilometer. That should be written as 6400 into 10 raised to 3 units. Okay. This 7000, I write it as 7000 into 10 raised to 3 meters. This is small r. So I substitute this value here. Here already you have seen 3 zeros plus 3. 10 raised to 6 you can write. Here also you can substitute 10 raised to 6. No problem. So let me write this r. 6400 into 10 raised to 3 whole square divided by R, which is 7000 into 10 raised to 3. Whatever is given, I have substituted. You need not worry. You can also shift the decimals for this one. Here in this case, what I just do is, let me tell you, 3 zeros are there, here 3 is there. I write this instead of 10 raised to 6. And this 64 I write, therefore I can get 10 raised to 5. So your value will become V naught is equal to root of 9.8 into 64 into 10 raised to 5 whole square divided by 7 into 10 raised to 6. I have reduced this values like this. Okay. Now by using the one calculator. 64 into 64. Here this will be just 9.8 divided by 7 into 10 raised to 6. If you equate,
finally you get the velocity,
orbital velocity, which is equal to 7.53. It is 7.573. That is 7.573 into 10 raised to 3 meters per second. Into 10 raised to 3 meters per second. This you have expressed in SI units. So we have written in SI units. If you are keeping in kilometers, also can keep, but they know where they have given that to keep the answer in kilometer. So finally, I have to convert into SI system. So we have expressed in meters per second. So please observe, in this orbital velocity, first we have written this formula. This I have taken and I have did not write capital R. I have written small r because we know orbital velocity is capital Gm by R. But here I have written small r. Reason behind this is, from here to here is R. Here is H, some height. Orbital velocity is launching at some height. That is, the one orbital velocity is at high, this height. So this h you have to consider. So I have taken small r equal to r plus h. Therefore I have written small r. So instead of this capital R, I have written small r. Right? This is first procedure. But in this problem, nowhere they have given mass. But g we know, but we do not have mass. So I have converted this into this using the formula. Since g equal to gm by r square, we know g r square is equal to gm. So wherever we have gm, we write gr square. But here capital R, then small r. You should not cancel it. This small r is different, capital R is different. So you need not get, you need not cancel this. Directly whatever the values are there, you are substituting, you are finally getting the answer. This is how you have to solve for orbital velocity. Okay. Now let us go for the next type problem based on potential energy. Based on potential energy. Maybe the problem number 15.
Gravitational
moon system. Earth moon system. Earth moon system. Now remember, here they have given mass of Earth, mass of moon, and also they have given mean separation between them. You have to calculate gravitational potential energy of the Earth and moon. So observe here. If you use the gravitational potential energy, you have to use this formula where U is equal to minus G capital M M by R. This is the formula we have to use. Okay. So now let me first write U is equal to minus G capital M small m by R. And you know capital M, let me take mass of the Earth, that capital, that is small m is mass of the moon. So I write capital M is equal to, that is Earth, which is 5.98 into 10 raised to 24 kg. Mass of moon, I write small m, which is 7.36 into 10 raised to 22 kg. And mean distance, the distance between those two masses, therefore we have R, which is equal to 3.82 into 10 raised to 8 meter. Mean distance is given. You had to use capital G here. They did not give here. We are trying G. Capital G is equal to 6.67 10 raised to 11 nm square, 10 raised to minus 11 nm square kg to the power of minus 2. This is what we have to write on our own. They did not give here. That is the only one we have to write on our own. And observe here, this is in kg. Here also in kg. Meters. It is also in newtons per minute. Newton meter square kg to the power of minus 2. All are in system. No need to convert here. Directly you can substitute. Where U is equal to, you can write minus 6.67 10 raised to minus 11 into mass, that is 5.98 into 10 raised to 24, right, into 7.36 into 10 raised to 22. This is the one, yes, distance 3.82 into 10 raised to 8. So using all this, you have to calculate here. Please observe, when bases are same, powers can be added here, and therefore you can rewrite like this. When U is equal to minus 6.67 into, first I write these values, 5.98 into 7.36 into, here I write 10 raised to minus 11 plus 24 plus 22. Okay? Right. Divided by 3.82. Here 10 raised to plus 8, I take this to numerator, which becomes minus. So I add here itself. It is 10 raised to minus 8. Please observe here. This is 20 minus 11 minus 8 is minus 19. Here 24 plus 22. These two you have to add, and these two should be subtracted. And by just using multiplication, simple multiplication, we get the answer for energy, which is equal to minus 7.68 10 raised to, here it becomes minus 11 minus 8 minus 19. If it goes here, then it will be 5 plus 22 is 27. By just multiplying, I think you will get, which is equal to 10 raised to 28. Right. This is the expressed difference. Here very simple problem. But here remember, this you are writing on your own. This is one step, that is capital G, and all are given in SI system. No need to convert here. Directly they have given mass of Earth, mass of moon. By looking to the values, you can decide mass of Earth is more than mass of moon. capital M is mass of Earth, small m is mass of Moon. The distance between them is represented by R. Written this as distance between them. Okay, now substituting you get, and I am just writing here, when bases are same, powers can be added. So I have equated all the bases here, and then base powers can be added here. And this denominator also have taken to the numerator, power you get minus 18. So these are the steps to be followed to calculate this potential energy. Okay. Now let us go for one more problem where it is gravitational potential. Let us go for gravitational potential. Problem number 16.
R is equal to 8900 into 10 raised to 3
instead of this is minus G capital R square divided by small r. I think you are able to catch this formula now. I did not write capital R now because I need R plus H. I cannot cancel this. Okay, I think you have followed this formula. Right? Now I write values for this one, G and R. So V is equal to G is minus 9.8 into R. R is 6400 into 10 raised to 3. I write in meters. I think you are following. Kilometers will be converted to meters divided by this R. Directly I write 89 into 10 raised to 5 meters. Right? This is how we have to reduce the formula and we have to substitute it. Okay, even this can also be written as 10 raised to 5 whole square. That can be written, you can easily write it. But now finally you get the answer for V, which is minus 45.61. 45.61 into 10 raised to 6. 10 raised to 6. But we are writing units now. Please observe gravitational potential. Gravitational potential energy per unit mass we write. So the unit is joules per kg. It is joules per kg. Hope you have understood the one gravitational potential, how to calculate it. Okay, right. One more we come across formula based on energy. Right? So let me solve based on this one more problem of the energies. Maybe problem number 17. Calculate. In this first one, kinetic energy. Second one, potential energy.
Which is 6400 kilometer
is equal to 6.67 10 raised to minus 11 Nm square k to the power of minus 2. This is the one problem they have given here.
This is 10 raised to 25 and this is
R is R plus H itself is, it is 6500. 6500 into 10 raised to 3. Right? So this is how I have substituted all in, that is meters. So 6400 kilometer we have. This can be written as 400 plus 100, 500 kilometer. This you can write in meters, which is followed by 10 raised to 3. That is, in, which is equal to 6500 into 10 raised to 3 meters. This is how you can write for R plus H. I will write once again here.
Correctly, and you will expect one problem from this chapter. Okay, thank you very much.